ぱりセクハラしていたのね。
Shalom, Habibis!
And welcome!
Welcome, everybody. Yeah, give us 1 second to get ready. We're almost set to go. Getting our puppy all cuddled up between us. And I did a little bit of stuff off screen to try to make sure that we are set to go. Let's go.
Thank you so much for joining us for Telestial Gaming Streaming of Wind Waker. My name is Caitlin.
My name's Edwin.
We really do appreciate you guys being here with us. And before we start, I just want to request a like and a subscribe if you can. It really does help us out. Yeah. And then let's get right into it.
Yep, so off camera I looked up a walkthrough, and apparently, so I've run into these things multiple times, and every time I do, I got screwed and tattooed. But now that I have the bow, I'm actually able to take him on. So, we're going to do that. Yeah, eat a fart. I was so ready for chat, so ready for stream, that I literally, like, Googled, what do I do next? What is happening? Yeah, look at that. Just destroying everything to do with his entire life.
Whoa.
How cool.
Whoa.
That's a heck of an arm you got there.
I'm Peter now. And where did I? No one's been able to shoot me since before then. And obviously have mastery of the air. And now that you've established you're quite the Wind Waker, let's see if you can handle this.
Gosh, your voice is so funny.
I did it. I did it!
No.
What was it? Up, down, left, right?
I don't know what it was.
Okay. Down, right, left, up. Wow, I was so far off. Much better. Okay. And this is going to be our fast travel now. We can get around the world way easier.
Yay!
Okay, I'm not doing that voice anymore for the audience. So, how's everyone in chat doing today? I've been chilling out with my wife, playing Minecraft, eating pizza, and just decompressing from the hard work week. All work week, and I'm very tired.
To be clear, I was not playing Minecraft. Just Edwin.
Yep, just me. I'm building my own little fort and having fun. I love that we bought a server. I think it was a really good idea.
Tanner said he completely forgot the walkthrough that I sent him.
That's the walkthrough I looked up. I looked that up to get some advice, and then also I looked up a different one because I didn't have Discord open. Also, one of my favorite live streamers is currently live right now, and I was listening to her before starting today, and I'm like, she's so much funnier than me.
No, you're very funny.
But she's just funnier. It's not a matter of me not being funny, it's a matter of she's actually a genius. I love listening to her. What's going on, baby?
Ooh.
Whoa.
We're gonna get magical powers!
Oh. Oh. Oh, she's kind of scary.
Yeah.
Do you want to read this?
No.
Give me like a...
Tell me, little boy, can you control the wind? He's so young to have such power. How did you know to find me here?
The walkthrough that Tanner sent me.
I am the queen of the fairy world. What is the matter, my child? Does that not surprise you, young one? I like you.
Thank you.
And so, I shall give new power to the bow that you wield.
Oh my god, you're so cute. I want to kiss you.
on the lips. We're getting a really cool ability that I wish was in more games.
I'm giving magical fairy dust. I'm spreading it all around.
We have ice and fire arrows now. Oh, she's so weird. She kind of reminds me of the horse god from Breath of the Wild. A little bit. She's kind of eerie.
Yeah. Ice arrows can freeze the hottest flames, and fire arrows can melt the coldest snow. The berries in the fountain will ease your weariness. Use them as you need to.
She wants me to use the fairies.
Child, I must tell you, you are just my type.
I need an adult. Oh, he's so embarrassed. And he's like, stop. I know you're the goddess of this world, but you're embarrassing me. That's actually very cute. All right, time to use some fairies as I see fit.
Are you going to do the bottles?
Yeah, the R button doesn't work on this thing, unfortunately. Let's see. I'm going to hold on to that, but this I'm going to trade out. Yeah, there we go. What's chat up to? What's chat saying?
Oh, you got full health. Good job.
Thank you, baby.
Fruitful connoisseur is kind of creepy. Anna says, I decided to do more pit work while the stream is going.
Nice.
Tanner said, take a fairy to grandma. Fruitful connoisseur says, even the boat thinks it's a little sus. Hot person says, Caitlin, read this if you like turtles.
Ooh, tricked her.
And then I'm not reading the rest of what he said.
Oh, well, I'm really curious.
No.
Can you pretend to be someone else and read it so I can know what it says?
No.
Okay, fine.
I legitimately can't read it out loud.
Can I read it?
You could read it, but I can't read it out loud. The last part of it.
Oh, wow. Nice try.
Yeah, literally nice try.
Had her in the first half, not gonna lie. Tanner, I will take you up on that. That's actually a really good idea.
Taking a fairy to grandma?
Yeah, that's a very good idea. Well, okay, I'll get inside the old man. Fine.
Pop Disney says, I'll be back on the realm after I'm done with lifeguard work.
I will probably be back in the realm after we finish our live stream today. And depending on how late I want to stay up tonight. I've been having so much fun with Minecraft. That new realm kind of reawakened my love for the game.
Where are you wanting to go?
Outset Island. Help my grandma out.
Woo! We're spinny. We're spinning around.
I don't know why I have this feeling, but I think I want to head to Dragon Roost Island and then go south after that. You okay?
Mm-hmm. Oh, ba 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 is in stream.
Hey, welcome, ba 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 ba. Good to have you. Are you sure that's how many ba's? I wonder if they used to watch Bo 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 Bo.
There are six ba's.
Ba 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 ba. Okay, fair. Welcome, everybody. Thanks for hanging out with us. So, for those of you who might be new to the channel, because I knew we picked up a couple people yesterday, we live stream a lot every week. Steve is running a series on Mondays, which some of you guys probably haven't even heard him yet. We play Twilight Princess on Tuesdays. We're doing Minecraft on Thursdays, Wind Waker on Fridays, and I'm doing a series called Needy Streamer Overload on Saturdays. These Friday streams, are the best streams to talk to us. If you guys want to ask us questions or have conversations about anything, Caitlin and I are super open to it, as long as it's not going to get us demonetized.
And that's because Edwin is solely focused on the game, usually.
And Caitlin is great at manning chat.
Yeah. And that's why I'm there on Thursdays as well.
Yep. So.
Ooh! Tammy, Arrow, don't go, don't leave. Don't leave your poor old grandma all alone.
She's sleeping.
Yeah, she's just such a sweet old lady. I don't know how anyone could ever guess to give her a fairy. I don't know how anyone could have, unless they give you a hint or something. Because I remember figuring this out, but I think someone told me. Do you know what we're going to get? Mm-mm. Grandma's going to hook us up.
Oh, Sammy, is that you? Grandma is always happy to pinch that bright, shining face, my dear. Yeah, sweet, let me pinch those cheeks. Same, that's wonderful. Just, I don't know what I'm doing. Oh, that's right. You and your sister Arrow are trying so hard. Your grandmother, I'm the one who should be taking care of you.
Okay. She's giving us delicious soup!
We got soup! It replenishes all of your life energy and magic power.
And our attack power doubles until we finally take damage. Isn't that freaking radical?
Yeah.
Ah. And so full, there's two helpings inside. This just never stops being good.
That's right, Grandma Soup.
And she's making us more Campbells whenever we freaking want.
Hey.
Yeah.
Grandma Soup, it's better than Mom's spaghetti.
Yeah. Oh, we're going for the straight up disrespectful position today. You got my knees weak and my arms are indeed heavy.
And your palms are sweaty?
No.
Yes, they are. Your palms
they are
really
actually
sweaty.
Hands are always, my palms are always clammy.
Yeah, they are. Oh, gosh. Punim says, that's how Minecraft multiplayer works. It makes the game so much more amazing. And then he said, so what are you going to become a Minecraft channel and stop wasting so much time with these Zelda games? Tanner says, soup. Punim soup. Says, you forgot to mention the bottle she gave you that the soup is in. We already had the bottle.
Wait, did she give us the bottle too? I emptied the bottle so we could... No way!
Isn't that fairy? I thought that was our bottle.
No, okay, she did not give us a bottle. You trickster.
No, we already had that bottle.
What? But I... He wants me to hit him 100 times. Why do I can't... What am I doing wrong here?
I don't know.
Why does it keep doing that? Every time it says to do A, I do A. 19 blows. Nothing like what I could keep up with in high school.
Fruitful Connoisseur says, with your hands like that, I guess you can't play games like Street Fighter.
I absolutely can.
Clammy hands.
I can't. What is going on here? Yes, I do, but I don't know why I kept getting hit. Maybe I should have shielded?
Yeah.
That just doesn't seem right. I feel like you normally get... it gets treated as three hits whenever you hit them with the special move. I'm going to try it one more time. That one worked! Okay. It's working now. That's the one I like. That one's much more defensive. Maybe I'm doing it too late.
Yeah.
Like, he's too aggressive. Whoa.
Yeah, and you lose hurts.
Okay, that one didn't even warn me. I'm done. I'm not doing this over and over again. I'm just gonna keep getting 9 more blows than last time. And I think he ends up giving you, like, a knight crest or something. I don't think he gives you anything good. I'll leave him be. Stupid old pot-bellied sailor. Like
Punisher says he's like a he's like Markiplier, definitely not a masochist.
By the way, I do like Minecraft. I don't think I love it enough to make it the channel, and it's not up to me anyways. The channel is everybody's. So, all 6 of us. Yeah, Tanner's. We gotta officiate Tanner.
Ba 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 black sheep. Just kidding, it's just ba 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 ba.
Someone new in chat named ba 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 ba.
Did you see my dragon build in Minecraft?
I did! Made of the nether? That was so cool! I saw that when I came by to visit. It was really, really cool. You're doing a fantastic job. We got a bunch of creative minds in there. Mm-hmm. Bunch of creative minds.
So cool.
It's very cool.
So
I like
cool
it.
So cool, sewing and all. Demon Child says, hoi!
Hoi! Good to see you, demon child.
Fruitful connoisseur says the test ends when he hits you, so just avoid his attacks and keep hitting him.
I'm not worried about it. I think that I could have done it, but... So, as a streamer, I never want to get to a point where I'm just, like, doing the same thing wrong over and over again. That's Tanner's cue to be like, oh, so every stream you've ever done, right? But I'm not going to let it bother me. Where is it? I hear it. I can almost see it.
Dreaming. There's a voice inside my head.
We should ask Chad if they would like the idea that we had off camera.
About the Reddit?
Yeah.
Okay, guys, I don't know if any of you guys are familiar with the Reddit thread of AITA, which means Am I the Butthole?
Am I the Butthole?
But obviously the grown-up word for it. Just wondering if any of you guys would like us to read those and you guys comment whether or not the person who's asking is the butthole or not.
Yeah, I think a good way to go would be for Caitlin to read it off and then for us to give our thoughts and then to read what you guys have to say, especially if you have hot takes.
Yeah.
Love me some hot takes. I missed it? How did I miss it? Lame. That's picky.
That was picky.
That's picky. Give me the goo.
That was picky.
Yeah, look at that money. Love that money. So I think we're heading to...
One Up says, I haven't seen it in person, but I do see the news post about it. Demon Tossa was my community center okay?
The community center? Are you talking about the shop?
KY got my part of the base flooded up for a bit.
That's unfortunate.
Punup says, you know, most of us aren't here for the game, right? We're here to watch you, even if you are struggling to play a game for a half an hour.
I know. And I really appreciate that. If I had an audience of people that was only here for the game, that would make me even more anxious. But I still want to, I want to do a good job. Am I not doing that right?
You're supposed to do that.
Yeah, I know I'm supposed to freeze something.
Patrick thinks his KY can be a butthole. Tanner says, I think that would be funny for the AITA.
Okay, cool.
And Patrick thinks that it would be an interesting idea. And then Tanner said, hit the top.
Yep, thank you, Habibi. Shalom. And see, that's proof that I can read because I figured that... Wait, that wouldn't prove that I can read.
No, what was it?
Never mind.
You have a time limit.
I do. Before the volcano erupts again and busts in my face.
How are you supposed to get up there?
You're supposed to climb it. Ask me how.
How?
I have no idea.
Right there.
Yeah, that looks like a good lip. Love me some good lips. I hear birds. Birds sound like they're ready to assault me. Heh. I think I actually have stuff to do inside, too, once I get there. Okay. We chose right. We chose wrong.
Is there a hook thing?
No!
Use your leaf?
Maybe. That's actually a really good idea. So I appreciate it. And yeah, if I had people that were up my butt about everything, then I wouldn't want to play games that are high stress. But also, I start getting a little annoyed if I just keep failing over and over. It just doesn't feel good. Being a creator is sometimes tricky because you don't necessarily have an ego to you, but you definitely don't want to be just failing the whole time.
Here's your leaf.
Why? Why? It's because of the wind direction. What?
It is because of the wind direction.
But why did I bounce like I belly bumped it?
You belly bumped
it. I want to stab.
Ooh,
I want to,
We can stab.
Why do we stab? Okay, that was ridiculous. I'm gonna get murdered. Thank you, by the way, Tanner, for telling me to do the thing.
Tanner says go to the right.
Every time I do something right before he does. Thanks.
Yeah. For Volcano Sources, would you rather eat broccoli covered in peanut butter or spaghetti with chocolate syrup all over it?
What was the first one?
Broccoli covered in peanut butter.
What was the second one?
Spaghetti with chocolate syrup.
Okay.
I would rather eat broccoli with peanut butter.
Yeah, I guess so. No, I would probably do spaghetti. Both of them sound miserable, though. You did a really good job picking two things that I really don't want anything to do with. I'm proud of you.
Zing Zong Ray's in the chat.
Welcome, Zing Zong Ray.
Also, we have 11 people watching.
Wow. Well, you guys are all freaking cool. Thanks for hanging out with us.
Pop just says, did you see my part of the base?
I did, like, earlier today, but I haven't for a while. What is happening? What? Ah. And then give you some, yeah. Maybe I gotta kill everybody?
Ooh, use your arrows.
Oh. Maybe. Yeah, I bet the ice arrows actually destroy everything here. Piss gem! Let's go! Love me some piss gem. I wonder if you just straight up die if you're not out of here in time. Oh, you're smiling. What's going on? I can now lift.
Why?
Look how serious he is.
Oh my gosh, it's the best.
I know, isn't that really cute?
That literally was the most focused little child face I've ever seen in my life. It's like when little kids have to poop. It's like, concentrate so hard.
I used to give myself headaches with how hard I'd push. I don't know why I'm saying these words.
I could have not said any of that.
It
would have
been really good. Ooh, magic goo. Yes, daddy. Sorry. That's awesome.
Babe.
I'm sorry. I apologize before I finish saying it. Punk. I'm not allowed to have fatherly figures.
That is not what you meant.
You don't know me.
In any case.
That's ridiculous how little you move. Get away from me, harlot. Eep! I actually have to look up where to go next. I didn't think I'd make it this far this fast. I think I'm actually supposed to go back to my mainland, yeah?
Did your sister get home okay?
What the what?
In the game, your
Oh,
sister.
No. She got kidnapped again.
Oh, yeah, that's right. Pop just says, I'm switching my computer to watch the stream so I can also play Minecraft.
Do it. That actually makes a lot of sense. Okay, so I did the ice arrow one.
Tanner says, go to the mark in the map.
Mark in the map? Really? Wow. Well, there's two. So what I'll do...
It's teleport.
This. Yep. Wait. There we go. And then we can zoop that. Wow. My brain just turned off. We'll do the upper one first.
Okay.
Hit up Windfall Island.
Go to the mark on the map. The top one, I think.
Okay, cool.
And
Pop
Tart Snake says we're nerds.
You're the best. And you guys are nerds.
Okay, so I'm going to read out a AITA.
Okay.
And then you guys just, like, we'll give our opinion, and then you guys can give us your opinion and let us know if you agree or disagree with us and why.
Yeah.
Alrighty, so...
I like this.
AITA. So, for asking my husband not to talk about family planning with his mom.
Okay.
My husband and I have a 5-year-old, and we have been on the fence about adding baby number 2 for a few years now. Okay. We have a big vacation planned this summer, and I told him after that, let's try and see what happens. We were out to dinner with his mom when my husband said, after we go on our trip, we're going to try for number 2 and see what happens. She then replied, well, you're a little too late for that, aren't you? Since our only child is 5. She thinks the age gap would be too big. I was really upset as I wanted this to be private since we don't even know if we can conceive again, and I just don't want the outside pressure right now.
Yeah.
He got upset with me and said it's just my mom, and said how shouldn't I care because he only told her. I am still really bothered by this, especially since she is very judgmental to begin with, and he thinks I'm overreacting and will not acknowledge that I didn't want anyone to know about our future family plans. He thinks it's no big deal because it's just his mom. AITA.
Okay, go ahead.
First and foremost, there needs more context. Did you tell your husband that he couldn't share this information with anyone? Because he's family planning too. It's not just like your family planning. He's a participant in this.
It's very personal though. That's almost implied. Like, there's a difference between saying like, hey, I'm thinking we're going to do ham for Thanksgiving instead of turkey, and I'm thinking we're going to have more children, for a very judgmental mother to hear about.
Right, but he's right. That's still his mom, and he still loves her, and that's still going to be their child, future child.
Yeah.
Future thought about child's grandmother. Mm-hmm. So either you want her involved or you don't want her involved. And if she's involved...
That's an ugly dichotomy. Either she's involved or she's not. How about this? Once they've established that they're going to do it, they tell her. Or they talk about telling her, not just a... Like, if you and I had a private conversation once about it, and then all of a sudden you were like, oh, someone said the wrong thing. I need the iron boots for this. I remember. Well, it's all good.
I don't know. I feel like if you don't specifically tell me, like, hey, let's not talk about this because we don't have definitive plans yet, I'm going to get advice, or I'm going to go and talk to other people because I'm excited about something. Like, the only thing I necessarily see wrong on his end is he said, we're going to try for baby number two. When she said, maybe we'll try for baby number two. That's the way the conversation actually went, because, you know, very, like, who knows. But me, I don't think that there really is a butthole in this scenario. I think it's just a misunderstanding, and if she wanted it kept private, she should have said that to him.
But you're assuming that she didn't say that.
She didn't mention it in her post at all. So okay. I would assume that she did not say it.
I think that the husband is a very tiny butthole. I don't think he's awful, but I think that it's pretty heavily implied and pretty obvious, like, don't do that. Especially because he told her something that's not true, that's obviously going to get her hopes up and raise expectations. I don't like that. I think that he was in the wrong for that. And then when she told him, like, hey, that's not cool that you talked to her about this, he said, it's my mom. Instead of saying, I didn't know that you didn't want that and I'm sorry. So assuming her story is the way she told it, I think he's a little bit of an a-hole. I don't think he's Hitler, but he's kind of a butthead.
I'm disagreeing with you on this one, so. But anyway, chat, what do you guys think? We gave our take.
Either she's the a-hole, he's the a-hole, everyone's the a-hole, or nobody's the a-hole.
Yeah, I don't think anybody is. I think it was just a misunderstanding. And I think that if she has some spoken, like, unspoken rule about keeping things private, she definitely needs to voice those unspoken rules.
You're an unspoken rule. You know that?
What?
You're an unspoken rule. How about that? Okay, this is the right way to go. So there's going to be another island where I get iron boots, and that's going to be what lets me go to the other area. Look at, ready?
I see. Oh, I see his face.
But look at.
I see.
Wait. No, you gotta look once I get it.
Oh.
He's got a really big head and a little tiny body.
I saw.
I do love that determined stance, though.
Hopter Snake says everyone sucks here in this scenario.
Really? You think the mother sucks for being upset?
I agree.
I think Pop. I'm just kidding.
Demon Child says, I think the husband is a bit of an a-hole.
Yeah. Who said that?
Demon Child.
Based. I agree with you.
Patrick Saint says they need to talk about this more. Fruitful Connoisseur says the mother-in-law is the butthole. I don't think so. The mother-in-law didn't really do anything wrong at all in this situation. I think you got that. Down, down, hole. Right, left, hole.
You're gonna mess with me more. Down, hole. Wow, that moves fast. There we go.
You did it.
Thank you. I learned Earth God's lyric. Cool. We're making progress. We're making progress. That is a Zora. A tiny Zora. I'm a Zora.
Does anybody else have any take on that AITA, or can I move on to the next one?
I think you can move on to the next one.
I'm letting chat answer if they want.
Yeah, I got you.
And then I'll be moving on.
You're right. Maybe someone is taking their time. If you guys want to read this, you can. I don't want to do a voice for every single character. But there's an argument to be made that the way that this world works is that the Zora evolved into the Rito, which is kind of interesting. I don't know all the details, but Tanner probably does. After defeating the hands of the Hero of Time, Ganondorf was sealed away. I'm all good. I just want to know what the Earth God lyric does. What?
Ba 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 ba. Humorously said, the 5-year-old is the butthole.
I actually think the unborn child is kind of an a-hole for putting everyone in this uncomfortable situation.
There's not even a child that not even created yet.
That kid is so frustrating. It's inconceivable. All right, the song that we just conducted is one that will open the eyes of the new sage and awaken within the sage the melody that will carry our prayers to the gods. Door that blocks your way will only open when the sage plays that song. Do you know who that sage might be?
Your mom.
Do you want to actually effing go right now? Because I will go.
Where?
Downtown.
Making my way downtown.
I gotta look up where to go next. I'm sorry. I need the iron boots.
Okay, so I'm gonna read the next one, okay? AITA for celebrating the birth of my son in front of my sister. I, male 28, and my long-term girlfriend 27, just had a beautiful boy and we couldn't be more ecstatic. The whole family is overjoyed except my sister. For context, my sister, female 37, so 9 years older than him, had been trying to conceive with her ex-husband for about 6 years, and unfortunately they didn't have any results, which caused their divorce.
Whoa.
This has, of course, devastated her as she's been really keen on having children for the past decade, give or take. After the divorce, they sold the house, and she ended up moving back in with our parents since they had plenty of room.
Okay.
His girlfriend gives birth to their son 2 days ago, and we had agreed with my parents we would stay over at theirs for a few weeks so my mom could help with the baby whenever we needed. Once we got home from the hospital, everyone was so happy. We were showing everyone our son. Saw my dad, and we just started hugging and jumping around the place while trying not to wake up the baby. My dad was like, "You did it," and I replied, "You're a granddad," both smiling ear to ear, just being absolutely goofy. We then went over to look at the baby, and in the process, I hugged my sister, who was standing there seemingly kind of spaced out. She immediately starts crying. I try to comfort her, but the mood in the whole room is shifted, and she just runs off up the stairs. Now we're left there standing. My mom gives me the eyes and says me and Dad shouldn't have celebrated like that in front of her. I told her she should be able to deal with it. She knew we were coming. I went upstairs, but she didn't want to talk. So, am I the butthole here for celebrating the birth of my son? And then he caveat at the end said, I am open to any advice or suggestions for future context. So.
Okay. Yeah, I'm gonna say, to be clear, because I was looking something up. Did he specifically say, like, they went over there to talk about and celebrate that? Is that what the get-together was about?
No. So they agreed, like, his parents wanted them to move in for a couple of weeks after the birth of the baby so she could help with the baby.
Got you.
The grandma. So the grandma could help with the baby.
Got you. Okay.
So they obviously had a conversation. The grandparents had a conversation with the sister beforehand and said, hey, I'm asking them to move in. Because he said in his post, she was aware we were coming over.
Okay.
She's aware that we were going to be here.
I'm going to say, so first off, I want to open by saying, I don't think that the woman who can't have kids is an asshole. Because she had an emotional outburst that obviously wasn't pre-planned. She's not playing the victim. And as long as she's not, if she's sad because she's like feeling pain for not being able to enjoy the same thing, that's fine. If she holds it against him and is like, you shouldn't have done that, you know better than that, then I'd say she's an a-hole. But if she's just crying because she's sad at what she'll never have, totally understand that. That's a very human response. So I'm letting her off the hook for that. I also think I'm letting the son and the father off the hook. They were celebrating a beautiful moment. Do I think it'd be a wonderful situation if everyone could be happy here? Yes. But the fact that they're celebrating is warranted, and the fact that she's hurting is warranted.
Yeah.
I don't think anyone's being selfish here. And if anyone's being selfish here, then everyone's being selfish here.
Yeah, I agree.
It cuts one way or the other, but definitely not, you know, in favor of one and against the other.
Yeah, I agree with you. I was going to say, I don't think that anybody is the a-hole in this situation. I think, absolutely, if you're having your first child, you should be able to celebrate that with your parents who are now officially new. They've never been grandparents before.
Yep.
You know? So they're excited that they're grandparents. So absolutely should be warranted and celebrated. And also, she was told ahead of time. Like, and she knew, like, in that moment, I think she was so overwhelmed. She knew she couldn't handle it in that moment. And she did something emotionally human. Like, she ran away from the situation.
Yeah.
But I don't think that she ran away because, in my genuine opinion, I don't think she ran away because she wasn't happy for her brother.
Right.
I think she was very happy for her brother, but was also very sad that she couldn't have kids.
The last thing I'll say about this is how these guys respond afterwards is going to be what determines who's the asshole. The guy just said, I'm willing to take any criticism, which is a big deal already. If she says, hey, I'm sorry for my outburst, I'm so happy for you guys, and he says, I'm so sorry, I wasn't thinking about your feelings, both of them are saints. If she doesn't apologize and snaps at him, and it basically depends on what they do now. That's how I feel. Oh, I'm sliding on my butt. Whoa, calm down, Link.
Putnam says he wanted to know
what
where his crown went in the Minecraft realm.
I took it off everyone except for Tanner, because it ended up, whatever settings you had going on made it so it was eternal nighttime and messed with the creepers. I didn't want that to happen again. Oh, God. Oh, God.
Tanner says, I think it was the goddesses who turned them into the Rito. There wasn't enough time between the games for true evolution.
Oh, okay. Fair enough.
Quicksilver is in the chat, but popped in to say he's getting into the Minecraft realm.
Fair enough. I like it.
Fruitful Connoisseur says he agrees. Okay. With you. He agrees with you.
Good.
Which I'm glad. Pretty both much agree with each other. Yeah. I don't think anybody was an a-hole in that situation at all.
Yep. And I like that the guy said, hey, I might have been wrong here. Give me some criticism. I'll hear you out.
Yeah.
Most of the time when people say hear me out, it's going a different direction.
I do also want to put this out, and this may be, you know, harsh or whatever, but I want to just say nobody is responsible for your triggers. You, as the person, are responsible for your own triggers. You're responsible for emotionally regulating your reaction to what is triggering you.
I guess so. I think if you warn someone and say, jeez,
This is tricky. If you warn someone and say, hey, please don't talk about this, it really upsets me, and then they do anyways, I'm not going to blame the person who just said, please don't do this, and say that they should have still regulated after giving warning.
Right, but if you know...
What? Why?
I'm sorry.
Why? Why?
I'm sorry.
Ugh!
This is hard.
This game's the asshole!
I agree.
Sorry.
I agree!
Alright, I'm ready. Sorry. Probably gonna have to reset it or something.
Michael Knight's in the chat.
Welcome, Michael Knight. Shalom, heavy bee. Welcome! We're playing a little bit of Am I the A-Hole.
Punup, you were the only one with a crown yesterday.
Yeah.
Why are we talking about...
He's asking in chat.
I got you. Oh, boy. I'm happy we're all on the same page on that one. Because that one's... I think that one's pretty cut and clear. I'm screwed. Oh. I'm not going to be able to finish this. No idea why I didn't jump there.
Alrighty. So, I'm going to read the one that I was reading to you earlier. Yeah.
I know, but I have more to do. I think I'm going to get inside there and then get killed. It's going to be really tight. Go ahead, you can do it.
I don't think that you have a time limit when you're inside.
I absolutely do.
Oh, I'm wrong. Sorry.
Whoa! I was supposed to be able to physically see that with my eye holes.
Oh, there's a hook.
It doesn't matter. I already lost. And now it's just going to drag it on and make me wait for it. There we go. Yay. I literally just have to run the timer down and wait to die. Because there's no finishing it in time now. Oh, that doesn't feel good. That one time I didn't jump, I just don't understand why I didn't jump. Am I supposed to climb up it? I still don't even know what to do.
Tanner says... if anybody else is unaware, there is now a Minecraft channel within Discord that you guys can post all the Discords, all the Minecraft stuff. I'm so excited and happy that you guys are so excited and happy for Minecraft, but let's try and focus on this stream and, like, your happy lives and stuff like that, and we can talk about Minecraft maybe a designated time later. But yeah, definitely put it in the Discord pictures for sure. Fruitful Connoisseur says, like, Piccolo in the abridged version yelling dodge. Someone needs to yell at Edward and say jump.
This game doesn't have a jump button.
Tanner says you can skip this.
Really? I thought you need this for the iron boots. Do you not need this for the iron boots? Fair enough. I'm still going to do it because I'm already here.
Oh, Quicksilver is not allowed to do Discord. I apologize, guys, about that.
Yeah, I'm okay with talking about it. I just don't want to... I don't know.
We can have, like, a designated 10 minutes to talk about Minecraft if you guys want.
Or we can stop doing AITA if everyone doesn't want to do it. But I don't know. It's not a big deal. Either way.
I like doing these AITAs.
I do, too.
Alrighty, so I'm going to do another AITA. Are you ready?
Yeah.
Am I the a-hole for implying to my mom I won't help her and my siblings out after I turn 18? Okay. My mom is a single mom and we struggle. I'm a 17-year-old male, the oldest, and I have four younger siblings, 14, 12, 9, and 8. We have two different dads. Me, the 14-year-old, and the 12-year-old have the same dad. He skipped out when my mom was pregnant with the youngest. She got, about a year later, got with another guy who had a mazillion and a half red flags that she just overlooked because she was desperate.
Sure.
Then she had two kids with him. After that, he stole from her and left and never looked back, which put them in a very tight position, which they already didn't have a lot of money to begin with. After that, my mom would lean on me a lot, and she asked me to step up and be there, and I did it because I wanted to help and be, you know, for my siblings and for her. And I was thinking, like, if I'm sitting here helping her, she won't need another bad dude in her life.
Jeez.
It was tough, though. Like, having to help with homework and feeding my siblings and being responsible for most of the cleaning was a lot. My mom still did stuff. It was just she had to work and couldn't be there all the time. But after a year or so of that, she started to take her frustrations out on me verbally. She'd complain about calls from my school. I struggled in school. Or if I forgot to do something, she'd tell me I couldn't let her down and I needed to act more like an adult and do better.
Jeez!
When I was 14, she asked me if I could start making money, and I did. I helped around the neighborhood for some extra money, and I got a part-time job a year later and gave Mom the money from that. But it was like she'd take it all on me and more. If I got home late from work or school, she'd tell me to cut it out and I needed to be more responsible. If a bill wasn't paid on time, she'd tell me to be less useless or be more useful. If I couldn't do something, she'd ask me, what good was I doing?
Jeez.
She'd tell me I wasn't a kid anymore and needed to stop expecting the life of one out of nowhere sometimes.
Oh my god!
Eventually, I got so tired of it and became so constant that I started saving money so I can get away ASAP. Mom doesn't know about it, and I still give her the rest of what I make because it's really the only way to save without her knowing. My mom expects me to stay here and help for the next several years until my siblings are all older, like of age.
Ooh.
I'll be out of the house as soon as I turn 18, and I won't consider staying for anyone, not even my siblings. Mom has been extra nasty lately to me, and she was saying I should start looking for a full-time job now so I can be, like, have a full second income in the house. I was like, bold of you to assume I'll be getting a full-time job to help out more. And Mom was then even more mad, and she told me I need to get over myself and accept my responsibility.
You can end it here. This is obviously, assuming he's telling the truth, his mom's an asshole, and he didn't want to know if his mom's an asshole. He wanted to complain and get affirmation for it. Like, there's no way that anyone thinks they're actually potentially... The point of Am I the A-hole is supposed to be, hey, I can't tell if I'm in the wrong in this situation. Is there any way you can help me? This guy knows that he's either lying to make himself look like a victim, or he's just in a really bad situation. We don't need to keep hearing about how horrible his mother is, and then at the end, am I the a-hole? He doesn't need to stick around, he doesn't need to help, he never owed that to her in the first place. His mom can suck a fart. The end. Are you mad at me?
Yeah, I'm not mad. I'm sorry, no, I'm not mad at you, I was reading chat.
Yeah. Yeah, I'm
reading chat. Tanner says, no, don't skip it. The win part, you can skip the win part by rolling.
Oh, okay.
The roll to the left and you can skip the whole mini dragon.
Oh, I'm out of...
Dungeon.
I'm out of magic. That's unfortunate. Oh, I wanted to finish fighting these guys. I can't... Ah! That's too bad. I ran out of magic.
Oh, I didn't know you could run out of magic.
Yeah, that green bar we got up top.
There's something to break. You're right.
Just
because who else can, you know, control the freaking wind?
That's a good point. It's a great point, even. But I'm going to have to ask you to stop being so cute. What?
Tanner's is drink your soup.
I'm going to drink my soup. And, from what I'm hearing, Punup, unless you're, like, being tongue-in-cheek, please don't talk about Tanner like that. That's not cool. Tanner's actually been doing a really good job with it. And, I really don't want that to be... This is what I don't want this stream to become.
Yeah.
If possible. Especially right now. Right now, in this very moment when we're live. If it's after stream, you want to have like a three-person conversation between me, you, and Tanner, we can do that, but...
Stream is not the place to...
Yeah, this isn't the right moment. So...
Demon Child said, geez, his mama's vicious. fruitful connoisseur says the thief is an a-hole. The mom turned evil out of nowhere.
Yeah, seriously. Well, just like the idea of expecting a 14-year-old to work for you? No, thank you. No, thank you. That's too much. A-hole.
So here's another one.
Okay, I'm ready.
Am I the a-hole for refusing to babysit for my aunt until she pays for my phone that her kids broke?
Say that one more time.
Am I the a-hole for refusing to babysit for my aunt? So her aunt has kids, so her cousins. Am I the a-hole for refusing to babysit my cousins until my aunt pays for the phone that her kids, my cousins, broke?
Okay, so with the context you've given, it really depends. If you're babysitting and you know that you're babysitting with crazy rambunctious kids and you leave your phone on the ground and then the kids...
She wasn't babysitting.
Wait.
So...
Okay, well, either way, whether you're babysitting or whether you're just around kids that you know that are rambunctious, if what you're doing you know could lead to your phone being broken and it's just sitting out on the ground and some kid steps on it, that's on you. You can't do that. That's you being dumb. If it was in his pocket and they, like, grabbed it from him and broke his phone, then no, you don't have to work to get that fixed. Whoever broke it or whoever's responsible for the people that broke it have to fix it.
Okay. So it says, my aunt and cousins are visiting from Boston. They are on school break right now, and I'm in school and the teacher's chill. They are both kind of rough, and since my mom and her sister seem to have a lot of catching up to do, they are out basically every day. That leaves me and my brother and my other sister to babysit, and they are basically no help. On Saturday, I wanted to actually make them baked mac and cheese, and after putting the butter on the pan, I went to go to get the flour, and I guess they thought it would be funny if they decided to put my phone on the stove, because they moved the pan and put my phone on the stove. I'd say it was there for at least 45 seconds before I noticed it. It was actually on the stove, and I took it off, but there was a burning smell, as well as the screen not really working. My dad sometimes will help me with them, but he was at the gym when this all happened. I ended up making them something else.
Wait, to be clear, he left his phone just lying around?
I think he had a recipe of baked mac and cheese that he was looking at on his phone. Mm-hmm. And he was putting all the ingredients, and it's a she, I'm sorry. She was putting all the ingredients together and looking at this recipe to make baked macaroni and cheese.
Okay.
And then after putting all the ingredients together, looked over and didn't see her phone standing up looking at the recipe. So she looked back over and noticed her phone was on the stove.
Oh, wow.
And she said, I didn't, basically your post was saying, I didn't move my phone, they did. Okay. And then I picked up my phone and I heard I smelt it was burning and the screen's not working now. So when they got, my mom and aunt got back, I showed them my phone and my mom was mad, but kind of became less mad when she found out it was my cousin's. My aunt basically said, oh, well. So I told her not to expect anything from me until my phone is fixed. At the time, we didn't get a deductible. And my aunt immediately jumped to the, I can't afford that, the phone fix being fixed was $175, even though she didn't even know the cost. My mom is mad at me for being rude. My sister is mad at me for being rude and making her miss out on quality time with her cousins.
Yeah, that's a rough situation. I mean, I don't think that you should be responsible to babysit anyone anyways.
Yeah, I don't either.
What am I supposed to do here? What?
Pam Bimbo's in the chat. Shadow City Guardsman's in the chat.
Welcome, everybody.
Tanner says hammer.
Oh, that makes sense. I'm just kind of stupid. Not gonna lie. But I can't get rid of my boots. Yeah, welcome, both of you guys. Good to see ya. Hope you're having fun. Whoa. Oh, I thought a big bird appeared above me, but it was just a tree. He's not... Look how much of a giga chat I am.
Yeah.
By the way, Caitlin and I are both significantly further away from the screen from the mic than we tend to be because we have our dog between us.
Mm-hmm.
And he's just so happy we refuse to move him.
Yeah, literally.
Significant quality drop in audio for our little schnauzer.
Literally. So, what do you think of that situation?
I have a hard time gauging it. I don't know. I totally understand the idea of saying, hey, I'm not going to keep doing anything for you until you fix this, because I think that you owe it to me. But I don't know what they're getting for babysitting anyways, you know? It seems like a bad situation. I wish that they could work it out, and saying I can't afford that isn't the same thing as saying I'm not responsible for that. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. You're not allowed to say, oh, well, since I can't afford to fix my mistake, I'm not going to. If that's the reason why she's saying she won't do it, then that's really crappy, poopy, dumb. Oh, it's a Kokiri. Kokiri. Kiriko. Korok. He's cool. Kokiri. It is Kokiri. Okay. So, I don't know. This is the one that I have the weakest opinion on. I don't think that the person whose phone is broken is an a-hole. I think the aunt is more for saying, hey, I can't afford this, so I'm not gonna do it. But also, I know for a fact if I was to go over there again with my new phone, I wouldn't let anyone touch it and I wouldn't take it out of my pocket. Because I know people are gonna mess it up. How old was the kid again?
The
kid that moved
in? The person who was babysitting?
No, who's the person that picked up the phone and put it on the stove?
My cousin was, like, younger, like, 8.
Yeah, okay. So, the person who's responsible for the 8-year-old is responsible for the damage to the phone.
That's what the person was asking. Like, am I the a-hole for not wanting to babysit if they're not going to fix my phone?
Yes, because that means that if the kid breaks or does something bad again, the aunt, again, is not going to take responsibility for it. And at that point, you say, well, I'm not going to let you do that.
Yeah, and they weren't getting paid to babysit.
Yeah, so at that point, I would say, hey, I'm not going to babysit for you again. If you fix it, maybe... Whoa! Oh, because I don't have magic. Do you see my leaf?
I do.
Isn't that weird? I forgot that's a thing. I should have drank grandma's soup. I still can. I'm going to do that. I need magic.
Here's another AITA.
Okay.
Am I the a-hole for expecting someone to pay half the cost of a parking fine that they caused me to get? So my friend, who I'm going to say is Skylar, made up name, and I made plans for me to spend the night at his apartment. I had never been there before, and when I arrived, I noticed that some cars in his building's parking lot had parking passes on their windshields. I wasn't sure if I was allowed to park there without one, so I asked Skylar if I needed to move my car to find street parking somewhere. Skylar told me that he's allowed to have a guest park in the spot assigned for his unit and told me a specific spot to park my car. I moved my car to that spot he told me was okay to park in, and then we went inside. The next morning, I went out to the parking lot, and my car was nowhere to be seen.
Whoa!
I went back into Skylar's apartment to tell him that my car had been stolen, and we needed to call the police.
Yeah.
Skylar's roommate then came in and said that my car was most likely towed, because at 10 p.m. or so, they tow any car in the lot without a parking pass. Apparently, Skylar was supposed to talk to someone in his building management to get me a temporary pass, and never did. I still had to call the police to get the number of the towing service that had my car, but thankfully I did find it, and the impound lot wasn't very far away, so I was able to walk there and get my car. I was charged a fine of $186 for illegally parking in the lot and had to pay that much for them to release my car. I did ask them if I could get the fee waived if I had some documentation from the owner of the unit stating that I had permission to park there, but they said it didn't work like that and I still had to pay. So after that, when I updated Skylar on the situation, I asked him to split the cost of the ticket with me and pay the $93. Skylar said absolutely not, because it was my car and so I was on my own. I said that wasn't fair, since it was his fault I got towed, and that he should actually be paying the full amount, but I was only asking for half because I was trying to be a nice friend.
Yeah.
Skylar just repeated that expecting him to pay for my car was ridiculous. I didn't want to argue about it, and I don't think he even had the money to give me anyway, so I just went home. I complained to one of my friends, and she said that Skylar was a jerk for not doing anything to help me get the car back, and it was fine to be mad at him for that. but she said that I was a little over the line expecting him to pay for my car expenses when he doesn't even have a car himself, and that's probably why he didn't know how the parking lot works.
That's a good point.
I don't get this logic. I still feel like Skylar owes me $93 and is a jerk for not paying half that fine. Am I the a-hole? Absolutely the a-hole. Absolutely not the a-hole in this situation. Skylar is. It is his, if he's inviting you over as a guest, it is his responsibility to make sure that you can park where you can park. Like, if he has a lot that you need a temporary pass for, that's his responsibility to make sure you know that. Absolutely make sure. And yet, you are correct. He should be paying the whole freaking fine.
I'm a little less strong on it. I think he's, if it's a guy or girl, I don't care. I think they're an a-hole just for not asking if they can help pay for it immediately. Like, if I give bad information to someone that causes them damage from a legal perspective, I think that you owe them what you cost them for giving bad advice. Now, if he said, if he had any question or any doubt as to whether or not she'd get a ticket, I would say, hey, you know what? He told you what he thinks, but he wasn't sure. And you went with his thoughts or his feelings.
No, he was not unsure,
though. That's what I'm saying, though. Is he said definitively, if you do this, nothing bad will happen to you.
Yeah.
They did it, and then something bad happened to them. I think that that puts the responsibility on him, and that he should have either given a clause saying, hey, I don't know for sure, or just said, like, hey, I'm going to cover this. I'm sorry. Also, that friendship means nothing to him. To the guy that gave the bad advice, because he's willing to just screw somebody over and then say, up yours, buddy. Again, assuming that the storyteller is being very forward and honest with everything, I think that the driver is not the a-hole, and the guy that gave the bad advice is both an a-hole and a loser. And you could do better. The end.
Yeah.
I think that it's very generous to offer to pay half of it when you got bad advice that you did not deserve. That's crazy to me, genuinely. I'm looking for Medley, by the way. What? I am looking for Medley. I hate to ask people for help, but if anyone knows where to go, it would be tremendously helpful. Otherwise, I might just have to pause for a couple minutes and look it up. I like to keep things moving along. Keep things moving along.
Keep things moving along. Moving along. Moving on up. You want to pause real quick?
Yeah, let's actually... We've been playing for probably over an hour. Let's take a short little break.
Yeah, we're going to just take like a 5-minute break. We're going to turn the mic off. You guys are welcome to chat in the stream.
I'm going to look up some info and try to keep things moving along. And we'll be right back, okay? Go for it. I hear her pling plonging. Do you hear her pling plonging?
No.
I think I hear her pling plonging. Listen. Do you hear the pling plongs?
I hear. Yeah, I hear that.
Where could my baby girl be? There she is. Wait, no. Maybe she's up there. All right, I don't think we're gonna... No, we'll take a break. I'm sorry. Okay, we're taking a break for real. Thank you. And we're back! Shalom, Habibis! Welcome! Yeah, I looked it up, and I was actually very close, but no cigar, so we're good now. And we have a long temple coming ahead of us, so that's probably going to be the rest of the stream. And I really want to play this one more time, so I'm going to... This was very fun.
I believe you. 25 letters, you can do it.
Oh yeah, I did 30 once. What? Frick! It's all unraveling!
Like, really bad.
I don't think I can get 25. It's giving me a weird one almost every single time. I sucked at this. I got exactly 25.
You did get 25.
I can't believe I got 25. Oh, wow. I don't feel like I deserve that. Three letters apiece?
Wow.
I want to try it one more time because I feel like I did garbage at that.
You really did do garbage at that one.
I could have gotten 32 easily if I wasn't stupid. What? Be a pal and give our new helper some pointers next time you're around. Oh, he won't let me keep playing. What a punk.
Maybe that's the last one you can do.
Maybe. Probably.
Okay, so here's another A-I-T-A.
Yeah, let's hear
it. But first, let me go to chat.
Okay. I hear those pling-plongs.
Can you guys hear us okay?
God bless America.
Can you guys hear us?
It should be working. OBS says it's working.
Okay. Here's another A-I-T-A.
I'm ready.
Am I the a-hole for scolding my niece for the way that she's been speaking to her mom?
Okay.
So, my older sister gave a baby boy up for adoption when she was 18 years old.
Okay.
For many reasons, she did not want to raise him and did not have the means to anyway. She, still lived with our parents, like I did. And she just didn't feel comfortable raising the baby, basically. Mia went on to get... Her older sister went on to get married and have three children with her husband. She was honest with him about the baby boy she gave up, and eventually she told her children as well, with the help of a therapist, okay, who said it was important that they know.
Sure.
This was 2 years ago. The kids got therapy afterwards as well. The oldest, my niece turned 18 4 months ago, and she decided she was going to find her brother and bring him back into the family. She made some comments even then at her mom that she should never have given him up and how could she not love him. Her dad stepped in and told her she was to never speak to her mom that way again. Kelly found her brother through an online DNA service. He had not used it to find family but to find out risk factors for certain things. He believed he had set his account and results for no DNA matches. But apparently not every box was checked correctly, and Kelly found him quickly when she had her results. She reached out and he told her he was not interested in knowing her or any of his biological family and to please leave him alone. He blocked her and then his account was gone. Kelly was so nasty to her mom, my sister, after this, and her parents kicked her out after she refused to stop being nasty. She told her mom she hated her, that she was a dirty little...
Jeez.
S-word. Slut. A dirty little slut and a terrible mother. She told her she had no right to give up their brother, and he should have been raised by her mom and raised with her and her other siblings, and her mom ruined that and ruined all their lives. She told her she didn't care what she went through. She was wrong. My sister was so devastated, and she tried to speak to her daughter and prevent escalation, but Callie, who's the 18-year-old being nasty to the mom, is furious. Callie reached out to me after a few weeks that had passed, and she told me she wanted to live with me. I asked her why she thought I would want her in my home after she treated my sister so badly. She told me my sister was a C-word, and she threw away one of her kids and denied them a relationship with their older brother. She told me I had no idea what it felt like. I told her she had no idea what her mom had been through, and it was not okay to take out her half-brother's lack of interest in a relationship on her mom. She told me I'm not her parent, so how dare I talk to her like she's my kid? She told me I didn't have the right. And I wonder, did I go too far for this?
Yeah, it sounds like... I think anytime someone's given up for adoption, is that what I'm to understand?
Yeah, so the mom gave up her oldest for adoption because she had him when she was 18. She wasn't responsible at that time.
Let's pause for just a second. I like this cutscene. Medley's learning from one of the Earth Sages.
I love this.
I do too. That's why I wanted to just pause for a second. It's Azora and Naruto. They're very related.
It's a fishy fishy. Get a kiss of fishy love. No, I'm not gonna do that because then Cosmos, you're barking. Look at that. It's the Illuminati. I'm just kidding.
Oh, wow.
I'm sorry. I'm sorry, guys.
That was intense.
Just kidding. I don't think that.
Look at all this work we gotta do just to get our sword shiny.
She's meditating.
Ka.
She's like frozen.
She is, yeah. She was like in a trance.
Like in a coma.
I'm gonna be honest with you, baby. I can't. The AITAs, they're really long like that. I can't keep up.
I'll shorten it for you.
Yeah, condensing them.
Yeah, I'll condense it for you. I'll give you the scenario again if you need context.
No, I think I'm good on that. I think my issue is that people are not asking, am I the a-hole here, to get an actual answer on whether they're right or wrong or if they're actually an a-hole. They're venting their frustrations about something bad that happened to them on the internet and asking for sympathy. No one ever in that situation or one of the other ones would think that they might actually be the a-hole here. The point of AITA is to say, hey, I think I may have messed up here. I'm not sure. Could someone tell me? And if there's no question at all as to who's the a-hole, then it shouldn't be posted.
Well, she's not the girl's mom. She's the girl's aunt. And so she wants to know if her words, like, went too far with her niece. Like, if she really overstepped her boundaries.
What was it she said again?
She basically said, let me go back to it. Give me a second. She said, the girl called me, my niece called me, and wanted to live with me. I asked her why she thought I wouldn't want her in my home after she treated my sister so badly. She told me my sister, her mom, was a C-word, and she threw away one of her kids and denied them a relationship with her. I told her she had no idea what her mom had been through, and it was not okay to take out her half-brother's lack of interest in a relationship out on her mom.
Right.
She then told me, I'm not her parent. How dare I talk to her like she's my kid? She told me I didn't have the right to talk to her that way.
But the thing is you just said, I thought she asked why... And then the aunt answered, and then she says, you can't talk to me that way? Then don't ask. You can't ask a question, and when you get the answer, say, don't answer me.
No, she didn't ask why she couldn't live with her.
Okay, then I can't keep up with these. There's something in my brain that's disconnecting from them, so I think I'm good on them. I keep thinking I'm remembering details that I'm not, so.
Okay, well, just stop them then.
I'm willing to hear what you think about it, but if I'm not reading it or something, I keep messing up, and I'm getting embarrassed. Get out of here, you seagulls. You think you free little punks are. I kind of like having my girlfriend here. Her hair is so not fluffy.
Her hair is not flowing with the wind like Link's cap is.
It's not at all.
Did you see it was just
like
straight?
That's weird.
While his cap is going up and down?
Yeah. Her hair has two modes.
It's like freaking weird.
Yeah, that is kind of weird.
Shadow City Gersman said, she's going to grow up to be a pro-lifer. I'll bet my soul on that.
Who is?
The niece.
Yeah, unfortunately, I can't picture a bunch of different people in my head. Like, I need Am I the Assholes to be, there's two people, one person did this, and then the other person did that. Otherwise, I'm just kind of too dumb to keep up with it.
Here's the very bottom of the situation. I'll give them names. Mia, the older sister, gave her child up for adoption. Callie is her oldest daughter she had with her new husband. And then you have Brianna, who's the younger sister of Mia. Callie's mad at Mia for giving up her baby for adoption.
Sure.
And calling her a bunch of names and disrespecting her.
Okay.
Brianna is the aunt. And is basically saying, like, why would you think I would let you live with me with you disrespecting your mom like that and calling her a bunch of names and blah, blah, blah.
Yeah.
So that's basically the synopsis of the situation.
But who's... The person in chat said someone's going to grow up to be pro-life. Is it the person who's put up for adoption?
No, the niece, Callie, who's mad at her mom for giving up the baby for adoption. She's like, how dare you give up the baby for adoption? How dare you ruin my relationship with my older brother? You should have raised your kid.
Oh.
And okay. So the Shadow City Guardsman is saying, like, Callie, the niece, the girl, is going to grow up to be pro-life because she's so mad at her mom for giving her baby up for adoption.
Oh, I've always been under the impression that people who are pro-life are pro-adoption.
Yeah.
That's one of the...
Pro-lifers are absolutely pro-adoption.
Yeah.
So, her mom was definitely pro-life because she had the option to do something else and she decided not to do that.
I will say this, a common either misconception or correct conception is that there are some people that are pro-life that do not give a crap what happens to the baby after it's born, which is pretty ugly too. I feel like they're two different conversations that are closely linked, but that's always kind of crappy when people are like, yeah, once the kid's born, I don't care, but have it. I think that's, like, I don't know.
I don't know any pro-lifer who thinks that way.
Well, I'm saying that there are some people who are pro-life that might say, like, yeah, of course we want all this, but they don't actually do anything in their life to help with it. Like, you and I actually considered adopting three kids once.
Yeah.
You remember that?
Yes.
And it's not that they were going to be gotten rid of if they weren't, but we love them and we care for them and we wanted the best for them and we were willing to turn our lives upside down. And we counted the cost and we discussed it and we were going to adopt three kids if the opportunity presented itself to us. There's a lot of people that talk the talk, but if put in a situation, they would not walk the walk.
I do want to say, though, that there's a lot of huge misconceptions about the foster care system.
Yeah.
Most of the kids in foster care are not adoptable. Their parents, they're in foster care, so the parents can rehabilitate themselves to get back custody.
Really?
Yes.
I've never heard that
before.
The
parents' rights haven't been severed.
I didn't know that.
Parents' rights have to be severed by the state first before a kid can be adoptable.
I never knew that.
Most kids in foster care do not have that severed relationship with their parents. They're not adoptable. And the babies that are born... Absolutely, there are very, very, very few newborns in the foster system. People want newborns. They don't really want, like, 10-year-olds.
That's true. And newborns almost always get adopted.
Like, 99.99% of newborns are adopted within the first freaking couple of weeks of their birth.
I don't know that that's true, but I'm not going to say that the likelihood of being adopted is the same as not surviving antibacterial for bacteria. But but I know a majority of newborns are wanted and adopted. But my point is, well, I don't know why we got onto this conversation.
That it was a comment in chat.
Oh, yeah. We were kind of expounding on that. It's a fun thing to think about. Oh, wait. Where's my baby girl?
This is a fun conversation. I like hearing, like...
You're a bird. Fly across the gap, you bird.
I know.
You're a bird.
She's a freaking bird. This is a little ridiculous.
You were born for this. Oh, but her little grunts.
Uh-oh.
She died. We have to go get another one.
Oh my gosh, babe.
You're wanted. I would adopt a medley. Just saying.
Just throw her.
That's a weird sentence, Caitlin.
You freaking have her in your hand. Just throw her.
Dude, her little grunts are so cute.
She hit the wall.
She did. She's so cute. I absolutely adore Medley. She's wonderful.
Did she make it?
Yeah, she did. Do I have to actually... I have to carry her. That's adorable. Do we hold hands or do I just hold her? Okay.
You hold hands. Like, your hands are up like this and she has hers on yours.
I used to think they were in our lock, though. They're not.
No, they are not interlocked.
Absolute Giga Chad movement. Oh. No one can see me.
Literally.
I'm unstoppable.
Oh, he saw you.
That's fine. No one can stop me now. I'm having such a good time. Throwing a
Where
girl.
Where is he supposed to go?
Whoa, did you see that big blue thing?
Yeah, I did.
Was that captured?
I don't know what that was.
What was that?
I don't know, but what are you supposed to be doing?
I don't know right now.
Are you supposed to go on that pole?
Maybe.
There's something over there on that pole.
Maybe I have to try the song. There we go. I don't know what this does. I thought it gives me control of Medley. But maybe I'm wrong. Oh.
Oh, did I... Oh, there we go. Oh, I just... Okay. Stream is being weird. Okay, let me look it up.
Hey. I don't even think I need the controller right now. I'm more curious how to do it. I think we gotta...
You wanna do Wind God's Aria. Up, up, down, right, left, right.
Up, up, down.
Right, left, right.
Right, left, right?
Yeah.
Are you...
I'm pretty sure that's the newest one you learned.
Yeah, but that's for the other one. That's for the Korok.
No. I don't think so. Why don't you just try it?
Well, Temmie. Not very confident, but I think I should try to fly. Fly. Just tap to... A to keep me airborne?
Oh, that... Throw her in tap A. Oh.
You just use the Wind Waker to guide me.
Yeah, I think you gotta do the up, up, down, right, left, right.
Here, I'll humor you. Up, up, what?
Up, up, down, right, left, right.
I moved her slightly. Yeah, that's not it.
Okay, well, I don't know. What the heck's a Wind Waker in this? Is that your wand?
Yeah, that is the Wind Waker. Got it. We might actually call the stream. I kind of lost my gusto.
Man Melody gives you control.
Yeah, I kind of feel like just calling it. I'm a little not in a good place anymore. So, we love you guys. Thank you guys for hanging out with us.
Command Melody. Left pause, right pause.
Yeah. I don't know how to look that up, though. I wish there was, like, a...
I have it right here.
I know, but I'm saying... Normally the game lets you see what you've done.
There we go.
Yeah, and then she's gonna fly across the button. I still want to call the stream, though. I'll do this one puzzle, and then... Oh, this is weird. My hair tie.
Oh, now it's moving. Oh, no, it's just straight. It's still just straight.
I'm just a burb. I can just flap. That's wonderful.
I feel like you need to keep something there. Like, Link's going to have to get across, and you're both are going to have to stand on it.
Maybe.
So you got to give control back to Link. After you stand on that, And then Link's got to get over to that one.
Link can't get over to that one.
He's got his leaf.
I already tried. Can I scoop him? Maybe I can scoop him.
No, all she can do is fly.
I already tried it, so I don't think that's it. I just want to call it. I'm kind of done for tonight.
Okay.
So.
Well, thank you guys so much for being here with us. We really do appreciate it. We also would love a like and subscribe if you can. My name is Caitlin.
My name's Edwin.
And I hope you guys all have a good night. Peace.
Love you guys. Bye.